Let's work through an example of calculating power and the probability of a type 2 error. Here I'm going to work through a two-tailed example involving a z-test on a single mean, but the same ideas apply in many other situations as well. Recall that a type 1 error is rejecting the null hypothesis when it is true, and a type 2 error is not rejecting the null hypothesis when it is false. And for the z-test we're discussing today, the probability of a type 2 error depends on the hypotheses, as well as mu, sigma, n, and the choice of the significance level alpha. And we call the probability of a type 2 error, we often call that beta. Alpha is our probability of a type 1 error when the null hypothesis is actually true. And we usually pick that ourselves to be some small value, like 0.05. The power of a test is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is in fact false. And note that a type 2 error involves not rejecting the null hypothesis when it is false, so power is simply 1 minus the probability of a type 2 error, or 1 minus beta. And so power also depends on the hypotheses and mu and sigma and n and alpha. Suppose we are about to randomly sample 16 values from a normally distributed population, where the population standard deviation sigma is known to be 8, but the population mean mu is unknown. And we're going to test the null hypothesis that the population mean is 75 against a two-sided alternative hypothesis. And suppose that we feel that a significance level alpha of 0.05 is reasonable for this situation. We might be interested in a question like, what is the power of this test if the null hypothesis is wrong and the population mean mu is actually 76? We'll come back to this question in a moment, but first let's look at another couple of questions that will help us answer this. In this setting, the appropriate test statistic is this z test statistic. And for what values of z will we reject the null hypothesis? Here I've drawn a standard normal curve, since the test statistic has a standard normal distribution if the null hypothesis is true. And we have a two-sided alternative hypothesis, so we split this alpha level evenly into the two tails, putting 0.025 in the right tail and 0.025 in the left tail. We've learned previously that the z values that make this happen are -1.96 and 1.96, and we are going to reject the null hypothesis if we get a z value that's less than or equal to -1.96 or a z value that's greater than or equal to 1.96. Now I'm going to ask this question. For what values of the sample mean x bar will we reject the null hypothesis? And I'm asking this because this will help with our power calculations in a little bit. Here's all of our information so far. We are rejecting the null hypothesis if the z value that we get is less than or equal to -1.96 or greater than or equal to 1.96. But this is the z-test statistic, and we have our other information up here. And so we are going to reject the null hypothesis if x-bar minus mu naught, which is 75, over sigma, which is 8, divided by root n, which is 16, if that quantity is less than or equal to -1.96, because that's our z-test statistic. And if we work this out, we would see that we would reject the null hypothesis if x bar is less than or equal to 71.08. Similarly on the other side, we'll reject the null hypothesis if x bar minus mu naught of 75 over sigma 8 divided by the square root of n, which is 16, is greater than or equal to 1.96. And again, if we solve this for x bar, we'd see that we'll reject the null hypothesis if x bar is greater than or equal to 78.92. Here I've drawn in the sampling distribution of the sample mean if the null hypothesis is true and mu is actually 75. This says x bar here, but that line might be a little faint. What we've done is re-express the rejection region from in terms of the test statistic z to in terms of x bar. And here we will reject the null hypothesis if the sample mean takes on a value that is less than or equal to 71.08 or greater than or equal to 78.92. Now we're ready for some power calculations. If the true value of the population mean mu is 76, what is the power of the test? Recall that the null hypothesis is that the population mean mu is 75, so if mu really is 76, the null hypothesis is wrong. And the power is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is wrong. So here, the power is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis given that the true value of mu is actually 76. Before doing any calculations, let's look at the appropriate areas we need to find on a plot. Here again is the sampling distribution of the sample mean x bar, if mu is actually 75, along with the appropriate rejection regions. Now I'm going to plot in a curve representing the sampling distribution of x bar when mu is actually 76. The gray area under the white curve represents the probability of a type 1 error, the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis given it's actually true. But power is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is false, and so the power is going to be the corresponding areas under the blue curve. So let's shade those in. Here, these two green areas combined represent the power of the test, the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when the true value of mu is actually 76. So now let's find those areas. This area in the left tail is the probability that the sample mean x bar takes on a value that's less than or equal to 71.08, given the true value of mu is actually 76. And we can just standardize this in the usual ways. You recall from what we've done before that z is equal to x bar minus mu over sigma over the square root of n. And if x bar is normally distributed, as it is in this case, then this quantity will have the standard normal distribution. And previously we learned that sigma in this scenario was 8 and n was 16. And so we can standardize this in the usual ways. This is going to be equal to the probability that a random variable z with the standard normal distribution takes on a value that's less than or equal to 71.08 minus what we're assuming to be the true value of mu of 76 divided by sigma over the square root of n, or 8 over root 16. And this works out to the probability that z is less than or equal to minus 2.46. And if we draw out our standard normal curve here, with 0 in the middle and minus 2.46 is out here in this left tail, and we want this area. And if we go to software or a standard normal table, we can find that that value to four decimal places is 0.0069. On the other side, this bigger area is going to be the probability that the sample mean x bar takes on a value that's bigger than or equal to 78.92, given the true value of the population mean is actually 76. And we're going to standardize this in the same way and say that's equal to the probability that z takes on a value that's bigger than or equal to 78.92 minus the true value of mu, which we're assuming to be 76 for the purpose of this calculation, divided by sigma, which is 8, over the square root of n of 16. And this works out to the probability that z takes on a value that's bigger than or equal to 1.46. And if we draw out our standard normal curve here, 0 in the middle, 1.46 over here somewhere, we want this area. And if we go to software or our standard normal table, we can find that that area to four decimal places is 0.0721. And the power of the test in this scenario is simply the sum of those two areas. And so the power is equal to 0.0069 plus 0.0721. And that works out to 0.079. That is the power in this setting. And if instead we wanted the probability of a type 2 error in this scenario, that's going to be easy for us to get at this point, because the probability of a type 2 error is just 1 minus the power of the test in that scenario, and that's going to be 1 minus 0.079, which works out to 0.921. That is our probability of a type 2 error. Let's look at a bit of a different example, one in which we're asked to calculate the probability of a type 2 error directly. If mu is actually 77, what is the probability of a type 2 error? Well, a type 2 error is not rejecting the null hypothesis when it is false, and here it is false. And so here that's the probability that we do not reject the null hypothesis when the true value of mu is actually 77. Here again, I've plotted in the distribution of the sample mean x-bar when the null hypothesis is true, which is the white curve, and the distribution of the sample mean when the null hypothesis is false and mu is actually 77, which is the blue curve. And we reject the null hypothesis when the sample mean x-bar takes on a value that's less than or equal to 71.08 or greater than or equal to 78.92. A type 2 error is not rejecting the null hypothesis when it's false, and so that's going to be the probability that the sample mean falls between 71.08 and 78.92 when mu is actually 77. And that's simply the area under the blue curve between those two values. So our red shaded area is the probability of a type 2 error in this scenario. And so we need to find the probability that the sample mean x-bar takes on a value between 71.08 and 78.92, given the true value of mu is actually 77. And we're again going to standardize this in the usual ways. We have our z is equal to x-bar minus mu over sigma over the square root of n, and recall again that sigma is 8 and n is 16. And so this is going to be the probability that the random variable z takes on a value between 71.08 minus the true value of mu, which we're assuming to be 77 here, and sigma is 8 and n is 16. The probability that z lies between that value and 78.92 minus 77 over sigma over the square root of n. This is the probability that z takes on a value between minus 2.96 and 0.96. If we draw out our standard normal curve here with 0 in the middle, over here we have our minus 2.96, and over here somewhere is 0.96, and we're looking for this area. That's our probability of a type 2 error. If we go to software or a standard normal table, we can find that that area, to three decimal places, is 0.830. That is our probability of a type 2 error in this scenario. And if instead we wanted the power of the power is simply going to be 1 minus that value, 1 minus the probability of a type 2 error, 1 minus 0.830, which is 0.170. Recall in the previous example, when mu was 76, we found that the power of the test was 0.079, and here, when mu is 77, it's 0.170, which is bigger. And this illustrates that the power increases as the true value of mu gets farther from the hypothesized value. If the true value of mu is very, very different from the hypothesized value, then our test is going to have high power. In another video, I take a detailed look at the effect on the power of various factors, like the sample size, standard deviation, and the chosen significance level.